Hi everybody, welcome back, glad you could tune in again. So, a little more applied Trinitarian theology, I think, we had a little bit yesterday, showing how the relationships between the persons of the Trinity help us to grapple with how best to handle disagreements between us. Let's think a little bit about how the character of the triune God helps us to think about the significance of similarity and difference. Clearly, in God, there is both oneness and plurality. There's one God, in technical terms, there's one divine essence. And at the same time, there's plurality, three divine persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And one of the things that we always need to keep in mind if we're trying to do Trinitarian theology properly is that the oneness and the threeness of the living God are equally significant. Some scholars have talked about the equal ultimacy of the one and the three. We should be as happy to say God is three in a kind of unqualified sense as we are to say God is one. And of course, for many people, that's a slightly alarming thing. Scripture says God is one in quite plain terms. And yet Scripture also testifies that God is three, diverse in quite plain terms. And we need to try and come to grips with that because it will help us not just with our Trinitarian theology, but it also helps us to think through human life and human experience. Remember, as I mentioned yesterday, that all of created reality is patterned on the character of God. Everything in that sense is in the lowercase I image of God, though of course people are in the uppercase I image of God, we might say. What that means then is that there are many areas of life in which unity or even uniformity are good. It would be really wonderful if within the church we had absolute uniformity of belief on doctrinal, theological, ethical matters. There are many things where difference of opinion is actually quite unhelpful, even destructive. And we ought to strive, as Paul says in the book of Ephesians, to seek for unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God. We don't want to be constantly heading off in different directions in the way that we think about our life and about our faith and about the living God. So that unity in the faith, if you like, is a mirror or an echo of the oneness that exists in God. At the same time, and you can immediately see where this line of thought is headed, if we believe in the equal ultimacy of the one and the many in God, we ought to be able to discern aspects of human life in which diversity is valuable, and indeed in which uniformity could be destructive. Now, these will be different areas from the areas in which uniformity is a good thing. The kinds of areas where diversity is a good thing become immediately obvious to parents as soon as they have two children, even two twins, because you immediately start to realize that the children you've got, though they come from the same parents, are really very different in character. And if you have three, four, five children, then you see that very, very clearly. With every new child comes a new set of likes and dislikes and temperamental characteristics and so on. And so for parents in that particular context, the challenge is to let each child flourish in the way that God has made them, not to seek to squeeze everyone into the same cookie cutter mold. They might all be your children, but they're different from each other. And one of the challenges of parenting is to allow that difference to flourish. Of course, we see similar things, not just as parents with our children, but all of us, whether or not we're parents, in many relationships. We will have preferences and hobbies that we like doing and ways that we like spending our time and kinds of conversations that we enjoy and so on and so forth, which will be different from people around us. And those differences are good. in many, many contexts. Just think how boring the world would be if everybody ate the same food all the time. Isn't it wonderful that in the church, just to take that one example, what God is doing is sanctifying to his glory a whole range of culturally diverse cuisines, all of which can be enjoyed by the people of God together as we experience the Trinitarian, well, echoes of Trinitarian plurality in the food that we eat. Well, the same can be said of many other things as well. And so one of the challenges before us then is to learn to appreciate the differences between people and the differences between different things that we might enjoy doing, while at the same time not allowing those differences to penetrate areas of life, especially ethics and theology and so on, where actually unity, even uniformity, is what we should be striving for. So just some things to think about in many different areas of our lives. I hope that's helpful. The Lord bless you, and bye for now.